Now we will see all about your capacitor, how it is going to store the energy, then what are the different types of capacitor, why we are mostly using in different types of circuits or appliances. You might have seen the fan in your home, so in that we are having that capacitor. So how exactly it works? So mainly it will provide some kind of, you can say, energy initially at the starting of that fan. So definitely that energy has been stored in this capacitor and which will provide it to the fan so that it will start. So that is how it works. So definitely for that it has to store the energy. So that is main use is nothing but to store the energy in the form of electric charge. So the same thing, it is an arrangement for storing a very large amount of charge that we can call as a capacitor. Again, you can say that its capacity is going to increase when earth uncharged conductor is placed near it. So if I'm having, for example, this is one sphere, initially it is uncharged, then I put the charge on this sphere. So I found that as I goes on adding the charge on this sphere, its potential goes on increasing. So you can write it down that Q is directly proportional to V. But after a certain time, definitely that sphere is having certain capacity to hold that electric charge. So after a certain time, it leaks away. So definitely there is some capacity for that. But initially, you can write it down that Q is directly proportional to V. If you remove that proportionality constant, then you can write it down as a Q is equals to C into V. So you can write down this Q is equals to CV. So capacitance is nothing but the total charge upon your potential. So again, if you want to define the unit for it, mostly we are using the unit as a Faraday. And the total charge is nothing but your coulomb upon potential. So to define the definition of your 1 Faraday, you can say that definitely you have to put a charge of 1 coulomb so that its potential is going to increase by 1 volt. So that capacitance is of nothing but your 1 Faraday. So you can define in terms of some standard notation also, that is basically the unit is Faraday, but mostly we are using microfarad or nanofarad. Again, there are now different types of capacitor. The first one that we will consist is nothing but parallel plate capacitor, where two metal plates which are separated by some finite distance. So that distance is D. So these are the two plates, and then definitely you might have applied some external field across it. So you can say that these are the two plates over there, separated by some, might be a dielectric material or might be a free space. So how the charge is going to develop across these plates, or how you can see that there is a transfer of charge will occur, or what is the electric field between them. So the capacitance is given by, for that, which is K epsilon naught A upon D, if K is the dielectric constant of that medium. So this is the final expression for that. But you can also find the detailed expression for it. So assume that the two plates having the surface charge density of plus sigma and minus sigma. We know that sigma is equals to your Q upon A. So that is nothing but your surface charge density. Then the electric field between these two plates, we know that E is equals to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. That is because of your this positive charge, and again because of this negative charge density also you can write down that is a sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So if you just add these two expressions, so which will give you nothing but your sigma upon epsilon naught. So this is the electric field between these plates. So we know that E is equals to sigma upon epsilon naught. Now, similar to that, you can find the potential, which is V, and that V, you can write it down as a E into D. So that you can write down sigma upon epsilon naught D is equals to V. So again, based on this also, you can find that capacitance. We know Q is directly proportional to V. So Q is equals to C into V. That Q is equals to sigma into A upon your V is nothing but C. So sigma A upon that is sigma D upon epsilon naught. So this sigma will get cancelled, and you can write it down that C is equals to epsilon naught A upon D. And if you are putting any dielectric medium over there of dielectric constant K, then you can write down that as epsilon naught K A upon D. So this is the capacitance between those two parallel plates in case of that your dielectric. So it is nothing but you can write it down as epsilon naught K A by D. So you can also say that is a K times of your C of your free space. So that is the equation for your capacitance.